Hi, I'm Raya. I'm a teacher with Toronto and Region Conservation Authority, and I'm out walking in my neighborhood of East York. My colleague Jasmine and I, we both live in Toronto, and we love to go for walks to explore the city. We'd like to share with you some of what we notice when we're out walking. Now, I'll admit, we are both kind of like nature nerds, so we see what's around us from a particular perspective in our own ways. You'll see what I mean. So stick around, because we actually have a challenge for you at the end. Now, one of the things I notice when I'm out walking are birds. I hear them and I see them, and I even sometimes feel their energy. They're so cool to watch because they're always doing something. I especially notice them in hedges like this in the winter. There's no leaves on these hedges, but there are often so many birds huddled in that shelter. And when I see them like that, I often think they must be having some sort of bird conference, and I wonder what kind of bird matters they're talking about. It's so cool. Hey, Jasmine, where are you out walking?
Hey, Raya. Well, I found that one of the best ways to be immersed in nature without having to travel too far is to visit one of your local public parks. Just a quick search online can tell you which parks are in your neighborhood, and my search brought me here to Masaryk Park in Parkdale. One of the first things I notice when I enter this park are the big trees that fill this space. I can imagine what they might look like in the spring when the buds on the branches are just beginning to burst, or in the summer when the leafy foliage is covering this park in shade, and even in the fall when the leaves are starting to change color and drop to the ground. But in the winter, there can be lots to discover as well. One of the things that I tend to notice about trees in the winter are some of those smaller details, like the texture of the bark and the kind of the shape of the overall tree. If we take a closer look at this tree here, we can see that the bark is really shaggy and thick, and hidden in the bark are all of these different colors. This tree is tall and straight, and it shoots up into the sky in one direction. Sometimes it pays to take a closer look. Let's go have a look at another tree. Wow, this must be the largest tree in Masaryk Park, and it looks super different than the other one. I can only imagine how long this tree must have been living here. If we have a closer look at this bark, we can see that it is so different. Instead of being shaggy, it has these kind of ripples that run down the trunk. And if we look up, we can see that this tree is shooting off in all different directions. Oh, I've just gotten a text from Raya. She wants to show us what she's found. Back to you, Raya. I'm gonna head down to the lakeshore and check out what's happening there.
Thanks, Jasmine. So, look at this. I came over to the west end of the city because I wanted to have a look around at Dairy Downs Park. And I didn't even get further than Jane, right near Finch, before I stopped to look at the trees, like you suggested. So having a look at this tree, I noticed the bark has the shaggy appearance that you saw, and I looked at the top and it kind of went straight up into the air. And I think this might actually be the same tree that you were looking at. One thing I love is that there are similar plants all across the city. So I could go to a green space or even the side of the road where I've never been to before, and I might recognize plants in that space. It gives me a sense of familiarity, maybe even a sense of home in that green space. It's like if you love a particular restaurant and you go to a different city or even happen to go to a different country and you see that restaurant there, it can give you that sense of home. Jasmine, you were heading down to the water. Where did you make it to?
Oops, I ended up a little further than I thought I would. Toronto's waterfront is massive. So this is where I've ended up, Toronto's urban wilderness, otherwise known as Tommy Thompson Park. Tommy Thompson Park is one of my favorite places to come year round, and it's where I always feel really connected to and just surrounded by and embedded in nature. One of my favorite things about Tommy Thompson Park is the fact that it's a peninsula, or what some people call a spit. This means a piece of land that stretches out into a body of water, in this case, Lake Ontario. Once you enter into Tommy Thompson Park, wherever you go, you're always surrounded on three different sides by water. Looking out across the shore and at the city skyline behind me, I'm reminded of one of my favorite things to do when I'm outside. This is something that really helps me feel grounded and appreciate to the fullest whichever outdoor space I may be in. Something called a mindfulness moment. Now, there's many different ways to practice mindfulness in nature, but what I like to do is to focus in on one of my senses in particular. That is my hearing. What I'm going to do is I'm going to make my body very, very still. I'm going to close my eyes, and I'm going to try to notice all of the different sounds around me, using my imagination to think what they are and where they might be coming from. Wherever you are right now, why don't you join me? Well, I actually didn't hear too many sounds. I could hear some birds chirping off in the distance, but mostly what I noticed was how silent it is right now. And that's pretty special in itself. What kinds of sounds did you hear? Let us know in the comments below. One of the best things about mindfulness moments, in my opinion, is that you may hear sounds that are very natural and also sounds that are a little more industrial, and that's okay. For example, if you're taking a mindfulness moment in the heart of downtown Toronto, you may be listening to some birds chirping, and then all of a sudden you hear the ee of the streetcar moving along in the background. That's just what the urban outdoors can sound like. Now that I'm feeling relaxed and grounded, maybe it's time to check back in with Raya. Raya, what are you getting up to?
I just love those mindfulness moments, Jasmine. Thank you so much for reminding me to take one. So, what am I up to? Well, as you can see, I'm right by a street that gets pretty busy, but we are going to go below street level. I'm in the Thorncliffe Park, Flemington Park area, and you might be thinking, Raya, cars zipping past, that doesn't really make me feel peaceful. I agree, it doesn't really inspire peace in me either. But right around these busy streets in Toronto, there are lots of trails that can take you to a much more quiet, peaceful scene. And I'm gonna head down one right now. Heading down this trail into the ravine takes me to a space where I notice a lot of plants around me, I see birds, and it generally feels a lot more peaceful and quiet. The Don River flows right through this part of the city, which means that there are great ravines to explore and enjoy. Maybe you live near a ravine as well. The Humber, the Rouge, or Highland Creek. With such an elaborate system of waterways in the city, it's like there's a whole other Toronto below street level. I encourage you to check it out if you haven't already. I think that's everything I wanted to share with you. Jasmine, do you have any final words?
Thanks, Raya. We've just been sharing different ways of how we get outside and enjoy nature right here in the city. Now we want to hear from you. What do you notice and what do you enjoy? Do you maybe stop to look up at treetops on your way to work? Or maybe you choose to walk through smaller parks instead of busy streets? Let us know. Our challenge for you is to take it a step further. Becoming a steward of the environment can be such an easy thing to do. Just encourage someone to join you outside and explore together. You are a nature champion if you're getting others to appreciate it as well.
We are so excited to hear about your nature exploration adventures. Let us know who you enticed to come outside with you. Maybe it's your brother or a grandparent. What surprised you or what surprised them? Write about your experiences in the comments below. And thank you for joining us on our nature walks today.